Hey everybody, how's it going? Bully Scholarship, we here. Welcome back for more Let's Play Paper Mario The Thousand Year Door. If you weren't here last time, we got started on Chapter 6 aboard the wonderful XS Express, and we actually have our own room right here. And we actually started doing some detective work for our friend Pennington, a penguin detective who looks like a detective. Very creative dialogue right there. But, so we're going to head over and visit him and see what's shaking, because this is the beginning of day 2 out of the 3 days. So let's see what's shaking. I believe he is in room 6. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy, there's something going down.
Ah, my dear Luigi, your timing is impeccable. A new case has arisen. Now then, Mr. Businessman, please explain the facts to my assistant, Luigi.
Okay, here's the deal. When I woke up this morning, my briefcase was gone. It contained all the contracts for our next deal, and even our new product prototype. If I don't recover it, I'll lose my job at the least. Now, calm yourself. The next part is vital. So tell Luigi very slowly.
Of course. Our company's new product is Nitro Honey Syrup. Used properly, it's an amazing product that can even raise the dead. But if mixed with the calcium from a seashell and a bit of gold, well then, the results are explosive. The resulting goo blast would immobilize everyone here in a sticky yet yummy shellac.
Shellac? I don't know what that is. This chapter is big words. It's fallen into the wrong hands. Well, I could lose more than my job.
You could lose your hair.
Let's examine these facts, shall we? Someone has stolen your briefcase. Though you definitely had it yesterday.
Indeed. And the train has not stopped at all in the intervening time.
Miss Mouse is like hiding behind Mario.
I have it! Rudimentary, my dear Luigi. Rudimentary. The thief is still on the train.
Aha!
Luigi, have you spoken to the waitress and the lady in cabin 2?
They've both lost sight on this train. The waitress lost shell earrings, and the lady, Toodles, lost a gold ring.
Luigi, if the same person who stole those objects also has the nitro honey syrup, it could make this a goo.
Oh, dang, I never noticed that before. Oh, snap.
So it is simple, Luigi. You must find that thief. We must apprehend the suspect before this dastardly plan is put into effect.
Well, I never connected that. Maybe I didn't pay attention to the dialogue as much as a kid or something, but holy crap. That's insane.
Alright, well, let's go see. It's probably that Zip Toad guy because he's the most sketchy of them.
Let's go see if we can find him. He's in room 1, I believe, actually.
Today's episode, actually, once we get going here, I'm going to have some time to talk about some stuff, and I definitely have a few things I'm really interested in talking about. Stuff with work, as well as video game collecting, and a few other things, so we'll get into that once we get through this.
Ooh, no one here, but we have a note. A vital paper. This looks like something very important and complicated.
Interesting. Wonder. This looks like something very important and complicated. Okay. Interesting.
So he's not here. Let's see what's going on in here.
Well, hello there, you cute, cuddly bear of a man. You're delightful, dear. Have you found my gold ring? Don't grow dust for now. I'm sure you'll be able to find it.
Yeah, hopefully. Well, I'd mention one quick thing. I've recently been looking on eBay. And a big thing I've been looking at is Japanese versions of retro games, so we'll talk about that later, but I thought I'd tease that at least.
Let's see. Nothing here. No, nothing going on in the room here.
Interesting. Well, let's go talk with, let's go talk to the rat guy again, see if he knows what this paper is all about. Because, obviously we can't read it. We're too stupid. Too many big words. I'm good at some things, but English, I mean, I can write a good paper, but just, I've never been someone who uses really big, fancy words. Never been that way.
Oh, not good. If I don't find a thing, I'll be sacked for sure. Okay, well, then let's show it to Pennington. Have you stumbled upon any new clues?
Yes.
What is this paper? What sort of clue is this sort of be? Is this supposed to be?
Oh, that's one of the contracts for my upcoming business deal.
What? I mean, yes, just as I suspected.
Luigi, where did you find this very important clue?
Cabin 1, you say? Yes, well, Ziptoad's room, a place I have long suspected. Come to think of it, I do not believe I've seen him today. Uh-oh. Then perhaps he is hiding somewhere on the train, always one step ahead. Very well, my dear Luigi, find that Ziptoad. Okay. Let's go back over here and see if we can find anything. And actually, while we're at it, I am going to dump some items. Let's see if I have anything in my inventory that's worth selling to begin with. Yeah, not really. let's sell the sleepy sheep. I'm never gonna use that. Anything else? Dried shroom. Yeah, whatever. Let's see if I can withdraw a few things. So this is what we've got. Wow, a lot of good stuff. Let's withdraw a few of them whack-a-bumps. Till he says I have no more space. Okay. Might as well sell a few of them. I can sell more off-screen or whatever, but... maybe we'll just do those two for now, because... I know we're gonna get some money later after this chapter, so we don't want to have too much where we can't accept it all. But then again, I can always spend some. Whatever. So, let's head on back over here and see what's shaking. Obviously, Ziptoad isn't in his room. But let's check our snap! Could this be another clue? What does it say? This document is just like the other one. The suspect must be in here somewhere. Well, if that's the case, what we learned last time... Oh, snap. There's a lot of creepy stuff with that. Is he just gonna sit there, or is he gonna move? Ha! Gotcha. Zao! Where'd you come from? You won't be catching me that easily, guy. You sure? Oh, shh! Ow! Wow, that was very anticlimactic, I gotta say. Oh yeah, now we're getting the... Okay, it must just be like the afternoon or evening thing or whatever where the lights change that. I love that. So this is our man all along, pretending to be Ziptoad. I see. All this while, pilfering things from others to aid your evil plan. Yes, this was all just as I had deduced. I knew all along you were a fake. Yes, a discolored nostril hair tipped me off. And not only that, but I knew that you were the one who threatened Luigi. Curses, I almost got away with it by getting off at Riverside Station, too. Yes, you played a darling and ingenious little game, my false friend. But the jig is up now, friend, and the good people on this train are now safe. That is correct, sir. No one escapes from this improbably large brain. Well, yes, in any case, at least return what you have stolen, Fink. Bleh. Set me up, sir. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you. They remind her of her ex. Interesting. Ah! My precious briefcase, is that nitro honey syrup safe? No. Yeah, here we are. The briefcase was returned. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank the stars it's safe. Now I won't get the sack. Yeah. Our rendezvous with disaster was diffused by my most rudimentary of deductions. Bing bong, bing bong. Attention all passengers. This train will soon make a brief scheduled stop at Riverside Station. Cool. Here we go. Cutscene. Ooh, bridge is up. That's not good. This is a cool place. I do like this chapter a lot, actually. And this part's actually very interesting. Well, that's awkward. Hey, I think not, Slick. You think you can hold me? No way. Beldum would flip if I let that happen. Oh, dang, I forgot it was Dupless. This whole Ziptoad thing was just a means to an end. It's me, suckers. Dupless. Beldum's plan to... Goofy Mario didn't exactly work, so I'll be cutting and running now. I'll leave the rest to Beldum. See ya, suckers. Wow, that's another thing I didn't remember at all. Dang. And I usually remember things. Usually. Alright, so with that, let's head on in over here. And let's give her her earrings. Oh, did you find them, my shell earrings? We sure did. Oh, there they are. These are my earrings. Thank you so much. Cool, star piece. Alright, you are the nicest old mustache overall wearing guy I've ever met. and probably the only. And with that, let's head over to the other room. I believe room 2? I think it's 2. The rich lady or whatever. It wasn't 1, because that was Ziptoad's room. Or Dupless's room, excuse me. More like Dupiss, am I right? Alright, have you found my gold ring, you mysterious sniffing master? Mystery sniffing? Whatever. Yes, that is definitely the ring I lost. Thank you, you glorious creature. I knew you would find it without fail. It's merely a trifle, but please take this as my earnest thanks. 30 coins, alright. Money, 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 money. Alright, so then, if we head back over here, I think we can exit. I don't know if this is the only door we can leave out of, but I guess we might as well. Wait. How the frick do we get off? Well, it's not this car. Maybe I have to go back to the right. This is really awkward, because I don't remember. It must be near the front. At least I think so. I guess I don't know this chapter as well. Let's see if, there we go. I'm curious if there's doors on every car or not, or maybe it's just on that one. Oh, well, even if there were, we'd fall off and die. So I guess not. Okay, hey, it's the rich people. What do they have to say? So little bub really likes trains, does he? Where does one buy a train? Shut up. Stupid rich people. Oh no, what do we do? Someone's lifted the drawbridge. The train can't leave the station. Yeah, I would say so. Good call. Safety 101. I saw a suspicious-looking shadowy person wearing a hat going to the station. He must have gone down to the bridge control room to flip the switch there. That switch hasn't been used in so long, I don't know where the control room is. So it's probably against protocol to ask a passenger to do this. But since you are the famous Mario, can you go flip the switch? Sure, yeah. Really, that would be super. Here's the station key. It's a cool-looking key. I like keys. Keys are neat. Can't go over there. What's fat guy saying?
Ugh, I've been cooped up in the breathing stale air too long. I want to go out and take a walk so I can build up an appetite for dinner.
Oh, yeah, okay, you do that. Pennington, what's shaking? Ah, my dear Luigi, our suspect was not only a fake Ziptoad, he was some monstrous being in a white sheet, which was exactly as I suspected. Too bad he gave us a slip like that, though. He was rather a slippery sort. We could have questioned him about all that Beldum business. Indeed, we could have. This is Riverside Station. We've stopped to refuel. There's a quaint drawbridge here from when pleasure boats cruised the canal, but hasn't been used since the canal was dried up and turned to pasture. Ah, interesting. See, you don't get that in the new Paper Mario games. You just don't. It would just be some generic toad who's like, ah, I'm afraid of you. And that would have been it. And there's a badge teasing us, but we cannot get that yet. Very silent in here. What does this do? Key here for an elevator key, or hole for an elevator key. Alright, well, now that we're here, I'm going to talk about what I want to talk about, which was Japanese games. There's something about it, especially on eBay. I enjoy looking at, kind of just like Japanese versions of N64, Super Nintendo, NES, Game Boy, that sort of stuff. And obviously, it's not something that, you know, you're going to sit around and play. I mean, it'd be kind of cool to try. Some stuff you can, you know, like some platformer games or stuff like that, you could obviously play and it wouldn't be a big deal. You know, game, but like RPGs and stuff like that obviously are pretty much impossible unless you speak very good Japanese, which that would honestly, if I could learn any language, you know, just out of nowhere, just be like, oh yeah, I know that, I can understand that, it would be Japanese, because that would be so freaking cool to just buy a bunch of random games you can't even, you know, you wouldn't have heard of or whatever, and then just understand what's going on. Play some of the JRPGs without having to get, you know, reproduction in, you know, carts or, you know, just English patches. That'd be so sweet. Let's fight one of these guys and might as well show them off. These guys, wow, just like Chapter 6 of of the original Paper Mario, we got these little rough puffs. And I probably shouldn't have used Flurry for this. Because she's not that useful here. But whatever, we'll just fight them like Vikings. Just take them down. So yeah, that's kind of a teaser there. I just today, actually, I was looking through eBay. I found a particular seller on eBay who had so much cool Japanese stuff. A lot of N64 games, some Super Famicom, but a lot of Game Boy, and a lot of them, you know, a lot of the things he or she or it had. Frickin' chicken. How do I get that? Jeez. Wow, that's sad. But, one of the things that I was really impressed by is how many different, you know, like, copies of one game this guy had. You know, like, you'd go to the store, you'd search, you know, Pokemon Red. He'd had, like, 20 copies of it, all different prices, I'm guessing based on condition and just when he maybe, you know, uploaded it onto his thing. But his prices weren't bad. You know, they were cheap. I mean, you could get a loose copy of Pokemon Red, you know, the Japanese one, for like $4 or $5, which was cool. And his shipping was pretty reasonable too from Japan. I mean, I was impressed. And he combined shipping, so I mean, it wasn't a great deal with shipping, but you know, the standard $4 and then $1.99 for each additional item, not a bad deal by any means. I mean, it could screw you over more. A lot of sellers on eBay, they'll shipping from Japan for just like a box Super Nintendo or Super Famicom games like $8 or $9. So, it wasn't too bad of a deal really when you look at it. So I found a lot of stuff that I, you know, kind of added to my wish list early, or not really added, but to watch list, and just stuff I checked out, and I was like, okay, well, I'll have to come back and look for more, because his prices weren't bad at all. They were more than fair, and like I said, I don't know the value of loose Japanese N64 games that well. Obviously, I'd prefer box, but I can't really justify spending $20-$30 per game, unless if I really like the artwork. Obviously, I bought a complete in-box original Paper Mario on the Japanese N64, which I found, I got for probably $20 or something, which that was worth it to me, because that's my favorite game of all time. I would also consider getting a Super Mario 64 one, because that's a really special game to me as well. But otherwise, the rest, unless I'm really that crazy about the box and it's a reasonable price, I'll probably just stick with, just loose for that. Oh, wow, I'm stupid. I almost had it. I just jumped. We're going to need to switch to coupes anyway. So that's a kind of a cool thing I've been looking into, and I'm not going to spoil, you know, what I actually got, but I'm really excited about it. It's a very special thing to me, so I'll be making a video on that when that shows up in the mail in probably a week or two. The thing is, I'm getting most of my stuff I buy online. Another star piece. I kind of just gave up on avoiding star pieces until later on. When I see them here, I just get them, I guess. I'm assuming you can come back here. I've never done it. I'm sure you can get back on the train and do that sort of stuff. But I guess I've never experimented with it. But they'd have to. I mean, I've never heard of in a Paper Mario game where you actually get screwed out of getting an item or a badge. So that shouldn't be a problem. And let's see. Station key goes to here. So let's head on in. So yeah, that's something that I've been kind of recently checking out. And, oh, interesting. First things first, though, before we fight these enemies, there's a little secret down here. You can get a nice HP plus badge. And let's see. Let's fight one of these guys. Ah, dang it. I was going to fight the spiky, but okay. Well, let's see. What have I got? I have anything that would be worth using? Earthquake. All ground-bound enemy. Nah, not really. Let's just do a basic quake hammer, hit those two. And let's see what Koops is. Ooh, nice. Very nice. Okay, let's see what, let's see, piercing their defenses. I don't really need that. Let's just do power shell, because these guys don't have any defense. But yeah, so I've been really getting excited over all that. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. Getting excited looking up all that Japanese stuff. And now that, like I said, now I'm actually getting pretty good paychecks from my summer job, I can put some towards games. Obviously, I'm not going to drop $100 a week or something, you know, on games. Every now and then, I might treat myself to a game or something, or, you know, every now and then. But that's it. I don't want to just drop all my money on games. Obviously, I have loans I want to pay off. I want to, you know, put a lot of it towards that. But every now and then, find a game for, you know, $10-$20 or some deal like that. I see no harm in doing that. It's fun to do it. And That's just kind of the way it's going to be. Yeah, that's kind of the recent thing I've been doing. I've got a couple things coming in the mail, I believe, that I'm going to make videos of. One was those reproduction carts as well that I was talking about in a previous episode. I definitely want to do a video on those because there's six of them coming, and I'm really excited about all of them. And then I also kind of wanted to talk about kind of my job. So far, it's been going great. I love it. The people are so great. They're so much fun, and it, you know, I didn't know what to expect with an engineering internship. I was like, well, what do they have you do? I was like, do they have you sit down at a machine and, you know, learn how the machine works? Do they have you stare at a computer? What do they have you do? And, you know, I didn't know what to expect, quite honestly, which made it kind of fun, made me kind of, you know, slightly get anxious. But I was like, crap, what are they going to have me do? What do they expect me to know? That sort of stuff. Yeah, it's been pretty interesting. You know what? I don't know which way I want to go down. Let's see if I can sneak past these guys. Yeah, I don't want to fight them. So, but it's a pleasant surprise. You know, I have my own little desk or cubicle or whatever. The people by me are freaking awesome. I love all of them. All the people I've worked with are great. I've learned so much. I trained with a guy who's really cool. He's been a fun person to get to know while working there. And yeah, it's been absolutely enjoyable. I get to use SolidWorks again, which is a program that I learned my freshman year of college. And I loved using it then, but I never got to use it much since. So I was really excited to get to do a bunch of that, some design work. Every now and then, just randomly, my boss or someone will walk up to me and be like, hey, can you draw this up on SolidWorks and design it and do this? I'm like, yeah, I can do that. You know, just stuff like that. It's so much fun. And I did miss out on a badge there, so I will have to go back and get that. So it's so cool where stuff like that happens. You're like, hey, can you design this or can you do this? So far, because they've had three or four, let's see, I think they have three other, at least mechanical engineering interns. And so far, I've gotten to do, I think, the most variety of stuff and the most random stuff, too. I think the other three have all been doing just the same stuff all day, every day, which kind of sucks, honestly. I don't know. I've been given all kinds of random projects and just random tasks, which I love. That was my favorite thing when I worked at Menards in retail, was just someone being like, hey, can you take this to receiving and can you, have them do this? Or like one time I fixed like some of the computers and stuff. At Menards, they have these TVs around in different departments, and it basically will display which employees are punched in that department. And some of them weren't working, so I had to go upstairs to like the server room, I guess. It's probably the closest thing you'd call it at Menards. And I had to pull out the desktop and like pull out a board and replace it, and it was fun. My boss was like stressing out about it. She's like, oh man, I hope I don't have to do this. And I was like, ooh, can I do it? And she's like, yeah, you can do that. Yeah, that's no problem. So that was really fun. I'm guessing we had to kill these Goombas to get this. I honestly don't remember. I feel so stupid. I'm guessing it's defeat all the Goombas and then you get the switches. But yeah, I feel dumb. I do not know this as well. Like I said, I have not played this game nearly as many times as the original Paper Mario. Not to say this is a bad game at all, but I know the other one way better. But that's the only pattern I can see here. Three Goombas, three switches. Oh, yeah. Oh, gee, I wonder what we're supposed to do. One, two, three. Oh, yeah. So, yeah, the internship is going great. It's a lot of fun. It's fun to actually have a... You know, Menards, it was a good place to work, especially in high school and part of college. You know, it's okay. But, man, not dealing with retail and stupid people all the time, that's just so special, so great. I bet there's nothing over here. Okay. That in itself has been so great. Finally just go in and you get to work and just learn stuff and... I don't know, use your head. That was the coolest thing. All right, and here we have the Ultra Boots. All right. This is pretty cool. Hey, it's me again, Toadette. It's nice to see you again, Heart. Way to get the Ultra Boots. Now your jump attack power will go way, way up. And you can use a new jump technique, too. Let's practice it right now. I know it's a little hard, but I know you'll get it. Just hold down A and rotate. Hold up. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. All right, so we jump. Hold it down. And, yeah. This is very useful, especially in the Rogue Port sewers. Once we get back, we're going to be doing a lot of that. There's a lot of new areas, like she's saying here, that we will want to explore, I guess. And that Shine Sprite that I kind of just ditched, we'll be able to get now. And as you can see, usually they're nice and they kind of have a spot on the ground so you know where to jump, so you're not just jumping in the air and hitting your head a million times, so that's kind of a nice thing. And same with here, you can sort of see the spot there. Oh, frick. And maybe not, you know. Maybe I should, try Yoshi out and jump across there and then do that. But, yeah, I am loving it. And, with retail, you never know how you're going to get screwed over. I know that sounds like a bad way to put it, but really that's the way it was. Like, with my job being sort of managing all the carryouts and cashiers and stuff, you could get screwed over so easily that it wasn't even funny. Like, so many people in retail do not show up for whatever reason. They don't feel like working, they blew their nose, anything. And some of them obviously have legitimate reasons, which, you know, that's fine, but it's, oh man, it gets old really quick going into work and being like, well, I wonder if I'm going to have enough people to close tonight, or if it's going to suck and I'm going to be doing, you know, who knows what. So I don't miss that. No offense to people, you know, if you like retail, good for you, because we need people who like it, because I don't. I don't like dealing with crazy customers all the time. That's just not my thing. So I am totally okay with not dealing with that this summer, and honestly, the summer's the busiest time too, so it's nice to have this now. And when I work there, it'll be in the, you know, fall and winter, which obviously Black Friday sucks, but everything else is pretty chill in the winter, so that I do not mind. But otherwise, that's really all I had to talk about that with work. The other thing, I guess, was maybe some videos, and here's an example, before I talk about that, my Spike Shield badge. Haha! Didn't do any damage, but at least we flipped him over. That was the main thing I was showing there, so there is a benefit of that badge, absolutely. And you can get those annoying guys. And those pokies, too. I could have jumped on them, but oh, frick. I'm just gonna cut these. Okay, just massacred all those pokies. Lots of money. Excellent. It'd be cool to get the money badge, but that's, that costs a lot of money to begin with, but maybe that's what we'll spend some of this money on. It's a badge we're going to want, and it definitely would pay off, I'd say. Pay off. Anyway, we're going to go back down here really quick. We drop here, jump, and then we just got to make this jump, and we can get a badge over here. It is the P up, D down badge. That one might be one to actually go for rather than the P down, D up one or whatever. Since, at least if we need more power at some point, because, at least, it'd be something to consider. It would cancel out one of the defend pluses or whatever, but, might not be a bad idea. Okay, so then the other thing I wanted to talk about was potential videos, you know, on this channel that I want to make besides Let's Plays. Obviously, you know, YouTube is not my career. It'd be fun to do, but obviously I'm not nearly... I don't have nearly the subscriber or, you know, fan base or anything where I could do that, but I still enjoy making videos just for the heck of it. It's kind of a way to preserve stuff, you know. That's kind of a thing that, like, it's just kind of the way my head works again. It's one of those things where, like, I feel like I really completed a game when I do a Let's Play on it, because I usually cover everything well, so it's also something that just brings me satisfaction, as weird as that might sound. Let's see. Am I even going the right way with this? No, don't need to be up here. So, yeah, that's kind of a thing. Then I can say, yep, okay, I really got through this game. I made a video on it, and so, I don't know, it's kind of weird, but that's how my brain works. So, doing Let's Plays, I do enjoy a lot. They're not you know, I don't do anything crazy where the editing is too challenging. Obviously, with Paper Mario, it's really easy. Spyro is a lot more because there was the dialogue. I would have to adjust the audio because, you know, with Let's Plays, you don't want the game audio to be so loud where it covers up your voice. Whoa, the frick are those things? Mario, have you ever seen beasts like these before? Do you think these things flip the switch, perhaps? We best find it quickly and switch it back. Yeah, I agree. Let's do this. I don't know if these guys multiply or not. Or if you can scare them off. They're kind of just sitting on the switch right here, I'm pretty sure. There we go. We scared them away. Alright, there's the switch. Excellent. Alright. And a bigger switch. Oh snap, I think we have a cutscene. Oh yeah. This music is kind of creepy. This chapter has a lot of good music, actually. Alright. And we have successfully opened the bridge, I guess. I don't know, it's kind of a weird way to put it, but, you know. Now, actually, there's that badge we can get. But anyway, as I was saying, the Spyro episodes, there were a little bit more work because with the audio, I wanted to be able to hear the characters because, not so much in the first one. I mean, you know, when you free the dragons, eight. But with the second and third game, there's quite a bit more dialogue, with characters, you'd run, you know, Zoe and all of them. So, I would generally have to adjust the audio, turn it way up and stuff just for that part. So that was a little bit more work, but, and with the overlays, but it wasn't too bad. So, I guess I never got to talk about what my plan for other videos is, but that's something that we'll talk about in the next episode, because we are calling this a day, because it's actually the end of day two. Anyway, guys, this has been Bully Scholarship. We thank you all for watching, and until next time, keep gaming, peace out, we'll see you later, have a good one.